Welcome to Think Tank. Again, use hashtag Adobe TT. With me, Daniel Raskin, CMO of Kinetica. Thank you for joining.
Thank you for having me.
I want to get into kind of like AI machine learning and how you can kind of create insight out of that. And you work specifically on kind of making all this geeky stuff, you know, applicable to right to business. So kind of give me a little bit of that.
Yeah, so I mean, our whole focus is thinking about the whole piece around not only how do you actually look at data to look at analytics and BI and things like that, but how do you actually use data to create core IP that differentiates? So if you're in banking or if you're in retail or whatever industry you're in, how do you actually use data to help become a category leader? And when you think about that, what you need to be thinking about with data is how do you actually operationalize it in a way where you bring all the key stakeholders together? So, you know, traditionally you have these silos of the business intelligence person, the business owner, the AI or data scientist, kind of often separate platforms. And what we're really thinking about is, first off, how do you actually bring them together into one operational platform?
Right, align those goals so that they're all pointing in the same direction.
Yeah, and then the other piece there is the foundation needs to be, we can't live in the legacy world of just thinking about the old data lake that becomes the data swamp. There's new innovations that we have to be thinking about to power data in a way where you can use AI in a proper way to create timely insight.
Yeah, and talk a little bit kind of about, I mean, because you have a human that's obviously programming this and figuring it out. So kind of just talk about that human versus machine relationship and how we kind of make that better.
Yeah, so let me first focus on the technology piece of it. And so when I talk about the foundation, one of the things that you need to do both human insight and machine insight is you need the proper horsepower to handle it.
Yeah.
So one of the things that has happened in the last couple of years is the whole idea of the GPU, the graphics processing unit, has turned out to be this amazing thing for processing massive amounts, extreme volumes of data. And the basis behind it is that in the old world with a CPU, you had 64 cores. With a GPU, you have up to 5,000 cores. So you have this big brain that you can pull together to process extreme volumes of data. Once you can do that, you can do really, really interesting things. So in terms of the human insight, you can do things like taking billions of rows of data and querying it to find different answers. You can visualize it in ways that you couldn't previously.
And that frees up time and energy to be, you know, allocated to something, you know, better and more specific, right?
Totally. This is all about data recency and how do you actually analyze this stuff in a way to infuse it back into your business in a really rapid way. And that's where the data scientist comes in, which is if you have them with their own tools in the corner office analyzing data, they can come out with fantastic results, but if they can't really easily get that back into the business, it's not terribly useful. So the idea is by operationalizing this into one platform, they can have their machine learning algorithms, they can analyze that across the same data that the BI person is using to analyze their data, that the business person is looking at the data that's feeding into custom apps, and all of a sudden you have one nice ecosystem for creating core IP with your
Which sounds
data.
Wonderful. Like, and you've talked and written about, you know, companies getting stung by extreme data. Like, talk a little bit about that and how to avoid those potential pitfalls.
Exactly. So I think what people tend to do when they hear the term extreme data is they immediately go to scale. And scale is one problem. I mean, billions upon billions of rows of data is a big problem. But it's more than that. When we talk about extreme data, we're talking about the fact that within an enterprise, you don't have this like very well-defined historical data that you're analyzing anymore. You have unpredictable data. You have streaming data. All these edge devices are coming on. And you have to have a way to actually infuse that stuff into your data engine, where you're streaming it in and analyzing it simultaneously, as opposed to having, again, that data recency issue. So that's one aspect of extreme data. The other piece is the complexity of analysis, that when you're actually taking lots of different data sources, you're taking extreme volumes of data, and you're trying to generate insight, you now need to do much more complex analysis, whether it be machine learning algorithms that you're applying to it, whether it be a polygon analysis, whether it be a natural language search. You want to bring this all together so it's not human versus machine, it's human and machine working together to complement.
Yeah, we don't want to fight that war.
Yeah, no.
But so for companies that haven't, you know, gotten well into AI or haven't even started, where do you start with that process? Because I think we've talked a little bit here about how you've got to have the back-end stuff figured out first or you're going to run into very quick issues.
Yeah, and so I think there's a lot of different on-ramps for organizations. I think first and foremost, we don't need to think about these as all unique spaces that have to be solved.
Right.
It's kind of like IoT, like when you talk to IoT for a car manufacturer. They've been manufacturing cars forever. IoT isn't this separate thing, yeah. right? So the on-ramps can be a lot of different areas. It could be putting in the foundation for translating that data into insights, so just putting in a GPU database, GPU infrastructure to handle that processing. It can be on-ramps such as location-based data and being able to visualize your data. There's very simple places where you can start, and what I'd say is, depending on your vertical, start where the biggest problem is. So if you're retail and you're focused on the omni-channel, maybe you want to start with geofencing and understanding that 360-degree customer view to get a better sense of who your customer are. If it's banking, you might want to be putting in the foundation for just doing human analysis around risk that you evolve to machine learning. So there's a lot of different entry points.
Let's talk future for a second, because that's always kind of the fun mm-hmm. thing about this. Like, there's practical application, and that's the most important part. But where do you yeah. see kind of that relationship between human and machine in the next 5-10 years?
Yeah. So I think it really comes back to that business problem.
Yeah.
The one I see the most commonly is the whole 360-degree customer view. And when you actually take all the different data sources coming from all the different divisions of an enterprise, making sense of that is really, really hard.
Right.
So I think what you see is a lot of organizations trying to break down silos to truly create that aggregated sense of who the customer is. And that's where you can start applying not only human queries on understanding different habits and behaviors and phases of the omnichannel, but also taking that and complementing it with machine learning algorithms just to make better sense of trends that you might not be able to pick out with the human eye.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
And again, if you want to learn more, go to adobethinktank.com.